All right. Well, praise God, praise God, praise God, you lovely, lovely people out there on YouTube and on Facebook and to this whole big old beautiful world. This is a big old beautiful world. I don't care what nobody say. If you've been on a cruise before, you can go to some places where the island water is blue or is green. It's just beautiful, my God. You can go to the Grand Canyon, look way down there. My God, you can go where the volcanoes are erupting. My God, God is a beautiful God. The world is a beautiful place. My God, you could go places, you could see mountains. And I like outdoors, so it's just, sometimes you can hear all the different sounds. It's like music to the wilderness, my God. You hear the birds chirping, you hear the frogs, my God. You hear the fish in the water making noise, splashing, my God. That God is a God that, I get excited talking about it because all the stuff he made and for how we to be such weak people and try to put him in a box like we trying to figure him out. No, you can't figure God out. He said through scripture, you can quote me, your thoughts ain't my thoughts. You're too weak. Come on. And your ways is not my ways. I can snap my finger and you can't be breathing. Or a heart attack. Come on, somebody. Or can't see. Just a snap of a finger. So that Paul, before he was turned, Saul, before he was turned to Paul, was killing Christian. Had a Christian, can I just talk to y'all a little bit? Had a Christian background. My God. But God hooked up with the trick of the enemy and started killing, beating Christians. Come on. And went on Paul to win. And if you read, Paul wrote all kinds of books in the Bible. Paul, go ahead and hit 4, 5, 6 books Paul wrote. My God, and he was the one killing. Don't tell me, God's mind too big for us. Come on, people. We arguing about stuff when our young men and women are getting killed and young people is on drugs. Teenage pregnancy is at an all high. My God, homeless is at the rise. My rent is getting ridiculous. Young black men is getting killed right in front of us. My God, and we got enough nerve to be arguing whether women should be preaching or men. Who the heck care? Everybody should be smart enough to know that God is the Godhead and man fell right under God. And then women and then the children. That's the order. The silence in the church meaning that God didn't want you up in no other man's face. Go to your husband, ask him questions. A pastor, that's the woman that's married, all up in the pastor face. Come on, I'm a pastor. I know what I'm talking about. I ain't just on here bamboozling you. I'm telling you the truth. So the truth will do what? Set you free. Pastor, can you talk to me in your chambers? I'm looking at her. You mean my office? Yeah. You know, my husband. You didn't come in there for that. You didn't come in to know nothing about God. And this is why God kept curves around us. Same way, how we know what I ask y'all what an apple look like, y'all gonna hold up a red apple. We're uniform. But when you study it out, how do you know an apple was called apple? Apple was not even called cranberries and all of these stuff that we eat, the vegetables, all of this stuff that we name tomatoes and corn and all of that. That may not even be the name of it. If you ask God, what is this, and throw him an apple, he's going to tell you something totally different that what that is. Why? Because he's God. We just uniform people. That's all we are. We're uniformed in the churches. We're uniformed with this walk. And you cannot be that. The scripture we're going to talk about today, it says that the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. We're weak. Come on. Look at you. You've been chasing that same man for 15 years. He ain't did nothing for the first child, and you got 4 children about it. What is wrong with us? You keep running after that dope. Come on. And you see it inspiring you down. You got to go deep in your belly and say, Lord, I want to stop this. You can need God to help you. Come on, church, talk back to me. I know what I'm talking about. You need God. Ain't nobody can tell you to stop doing something. You need to get a relationship right now. I don't care if you're putting that needle in your arm. Look at me. You need to get a relationship with Jesus Christ. Come on. You young sisters that's on Section 8, I'm not just talking about black sisters, because every time I be black and I say ghetto, everybody think I'm talking about black people. I'm talking about all people. You can go in, yoing, doing, excuse me, doing, 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 ding. You can go to that town and they got a ghetto. Come on. You can go to Canada. They got a ghetto. Every place got a ghetto. So they ain't not talking about just black people or black sisters. Come on. There's white hoes, Mexican hoes, green hoes, all kinds of hoes too. Not just sisters. No, I don't do that. When I'm talking, I'm speaking to the whole world. We in trouble, people. I got excited right there. Let me slow down. We too weak. We're arguing about stuff right in the church, right inside of the four walls. Now, she said something to me. She ain't no business talking to me. I wanted to sing the Sermonic solo for the past, and then I knew she was going to talk about she wanted to sing. Now they got to see who going to sing it. She knows she could have just, see, all of that. I ain't got time for that. I ain't going back to that church. You're not going back to that church because you and that guy are not dating no more. And you don't want to see him up in there. So you giving up God for a raggedy man or a raggedy woman. You coming to church just to see the drummer. Girl, he's on the praise team. You looking way ahead thinking that he going to get on TV and stuff and all that. We got so much stuff going on in the church. I don't get me wrong. I love church. I love the shouting. But I don't want to dance and then dance my way. Then when I get to my house, I'm looking at my house there. I don't even want to go in here. Come on, people. Drive around your house three times before you go in. Because there's so much hell inside of there. You don't have God. And I'm telling you, I don't care how tough you are. I don't care if you're in the toppest gang. I don't care if you got a daughter, if you got a mama, and you have your own body. God will have you bending on your knees, crying out to him. I don't care how tough you are. And I know I got some tough people out there. I don't care about no hell. I go to hell. I face hell. You keep on saying that. But it's real crazy when you can't breathe. Or when you wake up in the morning and you don't have eyesight. You better be careful what come out of this mouth. Because God is right now. God is not playing with us. You watch. I live in South Bend, Indiana. You watch how many tornadoes it be. Now God is a God. He's a loving God. He's still going to make it rain. For the farmers to give us messy self food. Come on, you eat every day and you say you don't know God. You ain't trying to know God. How you put something in the ground, an apple seed in the ground and a tree come out and you biting that apple and then you have enough nerve to talk about you don't do church, you don't do God, I don't do the crazy people. That's okay, don't do the crazy people. Don't do the church, that's the building. But do some God because you need him, if that make any sense. So the scripture we're talking about, it comes out of Matthew chapter 26, verse 41. And if it seems like I got attitude, I slightly do. But it's not at you, it's at the devil. Because you can't do nothing to me, not as a person. A people can't do nothing to you. Can't give me heaven or hell. But only God can. But I'm telling y'all something. If you don't know God, and you got a husband and a wife, you got children, you got a mother, you got children, I don't know. Some men love their dogs better than they like their woman because they'll walk the dog but won't walk your wife or your girl holding her hands. And you get licensed for to have a pit bull, but you won't get licensed to marry your girl. That's just a salad. That's a salad bar. That's the appetizer right there. That don't cost you nothing right there. Yeah. Some men get licensed to go hunting, go fishing, to get the special dog they want. Come on. A gun permit, whatever they need, they get licensed, but they won't marry you. And you sitting up there 8 years with this guy, and y'all playing house. And that right there, God blesses that. He reigns on the just as well as the unjust. But he allow you to keep laying in it until you should wake up and say, you know what? I need to marry you. Honey, we need to think about marriage or something. Because we got to understand, playing house is only playing God. We all playing God too much. Come on. Come on. From the pulpit to the guy that cut the church grass. God, listen, it's okay to dance. But I can dance and pray on the inside and y'all don't see nothing. When that overflows out of me, then if I have to, get my shout on, I get my shout on. But it's something that need to work from the inside, not the outside, because that dancing makes the church look like the pastor really gave an awesome message. Come on, slap your neighbor upside the head. God gonna give you a blessing. Mm-hmm. God ain't gonna do nothing from you if you don't get off your raggedy Annie and get up and make something happen. Putting in 5 or 6 applications, putting God first. God, give me, I need a job, Lord. Giving it to God and get you a job, get you a little apartment. I don't care if you have to let the bed out. $85 a week. Come on. Get that and clean it. Put some Fabuloso on it. Go to work. Work 2 jobs. Only thing you use in that place is to really rest. You ain't with no friends. You ain't at no barbecues. You ain't at Ray Ray Shanika gathering. Come on. You like the ants. If you guys watch the ants right now, they're not playing around. You know what they're getting ready for? The winter. What are we doing? Too much outer appearance. Come on. My God. Seems like I got attitude. I do. But it's not at you. It's at the devil. Because I am tired. I am tired of hearing about young. And I'm not prejudiced. All young men. But I'm black. To see the black man's getting killed like this. Now they coming up with another law. Now listen to this. I should run for something because I don't understand who's in these politics. Why would you have children come to a bar? You up there nursing your baby and you in a bar drinking. Are you in there with your boys kicking and y'all cussing and how belligerent people get and you want your children in that place? And when a fight or anything, come on, I've been in. Come on, what is wrong with us? And we as people, if we don't get together, they're going to do us any kind of way that they want to do us. I've been telling you, if everybody stop doing gas for one day, just stop. Everybody. But the problem is we got too many rich people and too middle class people that think they rich and looking down on people that really can't afford gas. See, if you got more, you're supposed to be thinking about the person under you. If you're rich, you need to be thinking about the person that's not rich. If you're not really rich, you're middle class, you need to be thinking about the people that's poor. Then even the people that's poor, there's somebody poorer than you. My God. Woo! Matthew chapter 26, verse 41. If you have your Bibles, that's Matthew's, and some of you should start taking your Bible. I do a lot off of my phone. I ain't tripping with nobody, but I am saying that this Bible, you hear them leaves? Come on, blow the dust off that Bible and get back into this Bible because it's something that the Bible do to your spirit more than that nasty phone. We all pull the nasty stuff on our phone, so I don't need to use the phone for the Bible all the time. It's okay. It's better to take that than your big Bible to church, but you need to show not people. God, why is the Bible so important to carry? Because it shows people that you're willing to learn. Come on, or be led to Jesus Christ, God himself. The Bible says, you can quote me, said, if you be ashamed of me, when you face my Father, I'm going to be ashamed of you. Come on. So don't be ashamed. That's what the Bible for. If you can't take your Bible to church, then that's telling God that I'm ashamed because I'm letting people know that I really love you. And that's a lot of people's problem. Come on. Matthew chapter 26, verse 41. My God, I can taste that word. Watch and pray, he starts off. Watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. Into temptation. Somebody said temptation. The spirit indeed is willing. But the flesh is weak. Now, if we dissect this a little bit, it said, first of all, let's start off, watch What's that noise? Honey, grab the kids. Let's be careful right here. I'm feeling something in my spirit. Get the baby's hand. Get your cart. Okay, let's walk down this aisle. I don't know what that was. Watch and pray. Come on, no. It used to be years ago you can come into a Walmart and you can let little Billy and let Susie go over in the toys and wife is over there shopping and you over there looking at tools. You can't do that now. Because once you hear a pow, gunshot go off, now you can't find your people. And you can't run where you know your wife was because that's where the gunshot is coming from. Watch and pray, people. My God, Lord, I thank you that I'm blessed. Thank you that I woke up this morning. I looked over at my wife. She was beautiful. Looked over at my husband. He was doing fine. One eye open. This is what time it is, people. I'm sorry. All the function, barbecues and all of that and all of that and the big party, all that I've been through and all that. And you can't stop people from doing that. But I'm telling you, be careful. It's dark out there. Come on. Watch and pray, he talks about. My God, or if it's okay, we just disturb you. I ain't got nothing to do. If you're done watching, just turn it off. That's the one thing about this. You can turn me off when you want to, but don't turn God off. This little funny tie, you can turn me off when you want to. How you can never watch me again. That ain't gonna bother me, and I know it ain't gonna bother you. But I know one thing: don't turn God away. I ain't on here for nothing but God. I'm on here to help you go to another level in your life. I'm supposed to pull as many as people as out I can, especially being a pastor. I ain't trying to see none of my church people drown. Come on. You better not even have a cell phone off at my church. Not in my church. If you a member of mine, ask them. Ask my members. If your phone get cut off, I'm calling my administrators. What's wrong with them? Why is their phone off? Now, if you don't want to talk to nobody, let me know. Then I won't be concerned about you because I ain't nosy that your phone off. That's your business, but not in my church. Come on. Keep your phone on. Watch and pray, he talks about, that ye enter not into temptation. Oh, Lord, I can preach this. I was tempted 3 weeks after my wife died. And she was very respectable, the lady, but she told me, if I want to get some from, y'all know what I'm going to talk to, you might have to, come on. If you want to get some from a lady for the first time since your wife died, this is what she told me, let me be the first one to give you some. And I've been tempted since. And here's the thing, before a man get, oh, did you hear what happened to Pastor Dean? Did you hear Pastor? You know, he dating this girl and this and that and this. Before that happened, let me tell y'all something. And men don't do this. Men don't tell that women is bothering them because it seemed too weak or it seemed like you guys going to say, he just lying. He think he's like, no. I ain't never had no problem with no women. No. My problem is keeping some money in my pocket. I ain't never had no problem because I know the characters of a woman a lot. She just want a good man that works, that's honest. It ain't hard to figure no woman out. Come on. She want a man. Hey, baby, I got it. Let me see who is this door. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. So there ain't nobody should be coming over here. Stay right there. Open that drawer. I got another one right there. Come on. That's a man. Sweetie, no, keep your money, baby. I got the car payment, but it's my car. No, it's our car. Come on, baby, we joined together, we won. Keep your money, you ain't gonna not help me if I need some, just keep your money. I told my wife that, come on. And I'm talking about a good man. I ain't talking about nobody trying to pull no woman around the house with her hair. You need to do that, nobody into that. This is 2023. These women got better jobs than a lot of men. Women can do a lot of better stuff than men, but God was talking about order. And if you don't like a real man, come on. And you men, sometimes you should change up. Get dressed. Where are you going? I ain't going nowhere. I'm just going to sit around you, looking good. You smell good. I love that when you get dressed up. Women won't every day. Songwriter can't say every woman like a sharp-dressed man. At least sometime. Come on. But we just kicking around today. You know, I'm feeling like, ooh, I'm way up. few minutes with y'all today, but we just got to watch and pray, people. Let's go back in here for a moment. Watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. So before, see, if you're praying, you're watching and you're praying already, then you never really have to get, the spirit is indeed willing to do right. I want to do right. I want to not go to this bar, but I'm going to go. I don't want to drink anymore, but I'm going. I don't have no power because you don't have nothing back in you. See, if you watch and pray, then you can see the attack, the trick of the enemy coming, if that make any sense, people. He said, and then if you have me as your Lord and Savior, I got your back. Where you are weak, I am strong. Come on, I'm your father. I loved you. I want to see you get better. He says, the spirit indeed is willing. I want to do right, but I can't stop popping these pills. I want to do right, and I blunt all my money up. I knew I shouldn't have bought that ounce for $135, and I know I got to pay my bills. My spirit is willing, but my flesh is weak, Lord, and I need you, Lord, to help me go to another level, Lord. Come on. You cannot shout your way to heaven. You can relationship your way to heaven. Not shouting your way, not the hair, not the nails. This is what he talked about when he said you don't need that makeup and stuff. If we take it to 2023, you need makeup. Some women need makeup, and then some women put it on beautiful. God ain't tripping. But he do give you a text when he talks about Esther. If you read the story of Esther, they took them 10 women and they groomed them, I think, for 6 months. Come on. Or 6 weeks, I don't know. I'd go back in my text. I know it was a while that they groomed them, bathed them in honey and ox oil and all this, and taking baths in milk. That's what they did. And then they had them dressed any kind of way. They put robes in there in the room for them to pick their robe when they go face the king. Watch this. And they had all the gold in the jewelry. They could put on all the jewelry, the gold, if they wanted to. And I'm telling you, and all them women is all dressed all up, looking like prostitutes. And the king was used to it because he had so many women after him. But check out Esther. Read what Esther did. The Bible says she put on a nice gown. Check this out. Nice gown. Fixed her hair up. It was beautiful. And put on one necklace. And that's what God has said. Be beautiful on the inside. And you don't need all that garbage that's keeping you from paying your bills, keeping you having attitude, keeping you being depressed. God made it where you're young, you can grow hair. You're young, you can grow nails. Come on, and you already got eyelashes. Don't let that outer stuff determine who you are. You're beautiful because God made you first. If that make any sense. I'm gonna leave you alone. That's Matthew's chapter 26, verse 41. Read it for yourself. People that's going to church, it's time to watch and pray. I love y'all. Be blessed.